CIET NCERT presents Raindrops, textbook in English for Class 2, special series.
About the book. The National Curriculum Framework NCF 2005 suggests that plurality of textbooks is a necessary requirement for curricular freedom. A single textbook does not meet the expectations and aspirations of teachers and learners uniformly. The same idea has been reinforced in the focus group position paper on the teaching of English, which suggests that the earlier practice of choosing from a range of available texts can be revived. It would be reasonable to expect that with a multiplicity of English textbooks, the diversity of English language environments in the country would be addressed better.
A series of textbooks in English, Raindrops, for the primary stage, classes 1st to 5th, has been developed. Keeping in mind first-generation schoolgoers as well as children whose only exposure to English is in school, and even within the school, usually with limited time duration and constraints in quality.
The criterion that we must meet is people's aspirations for their everyday purposes. In other words, to speak English, as against merely passing examinations in it or knowing its grammar. The aim, therefore, is learners' exposure to the language, in this case, English, in meaning-making situations so as to trigger the formation of a language system by the mind.
The concept of phonological awareness introduced in Raindrops 1 is continued in this book. The focus in Raindrops 1 and 2 is predominantly oral-oral. Listening as a skill is usually neglected in schools. Children are generally not encouraged to speak in the classrooms, unless it is to answer questions put by the teacher. Raindrops 2 has activities that consciously focus on these skills. In one particular activity, children listen to the teacher and take the word that they hear her say. In another, focus on pronunciation of vowel sounds is done by using minimal pairs. On page 12, in yet another activity, the teacher is asked to make children clap according to the number of sounds they hear. This helps make children aware that syllables make up words.
The book contains activities that focus on rhyming, alliteration, consonant clusters, and so on. Themes such as environment, peace, and gender sensitivity figure prominently in Raindrops 2, as in the others in the series. The poem, The Mango Tree, is related to environment, along with a strong element of awareness of the number of creatures that the tree gives shelter to.
Illustrations are of primary importance and more so in second language textbook. Illustrations are not mere add-ons to the lesson, but form an integral part of the textbook. For instance, a dimension of inclusiveness is added to the illustration on page 13. The text of the lesson is a simple description of a scene. The illustration shows a group of children playing carom, with one child in a wheelchair participating in the game. The child is portrayed as being at par with the others, and the idea is brought out indirectly that what matters is her skill at the game. Moreover, the others have accepted her as one of themselves.
Multilingualism as a concept prevails throughout this book and in the series as well. This is especially true of Raindrops 1 and 2, wherein the teachers have been advised to encourage children to speak by making them participate in classroom discussion and group work, and to also encourage them to use English words, but not to reprimand them for using non-English ones. Above all, it is hoped that children would begin to not only use words but play with them. The present book is one step in this direction. Lesson 1, Poem, Action Song, page 1. Ring the bell and clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Ring the bell and clap, clap, clap. Sing with me today.
Wave your hand and clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Wave your hand and clap, clap, clap. Sing with me today.
Page number 2. Stamp your feet and clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Stamp your feet and clap, clap, clap. Sing with me today.
Turn around and clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Turn around and clap, clap, clap. Sing with me today.
Let's try this.
1. Can you think of some other actions to accompany the song?
2. Underline the word that is used the most in the poem.
3. Underline the sentence that is used at the end of every 3 lines.
To the teacher. Sing the song with actions and make the children repeat it after you.
Help them underline, clap, 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 and sing with me today.